Welcome to Colburn's A Serving of Beethoven, Sonatas for Piano and Violin live broadcast. My name is Martin Beaver, and my co-host is Fabio Bidini. As faculty of the Colburn School, it is our pleasure to present to you a Beethoven piano and violin sonata each Thursday at noon. In order to enhance your listening experience each week, we'll provide a brief introduction covering some background and insights from our personal experiences.
Before we discuss today's work, I want to take a moment to share that the Violin Sonata series is dedicated to a dear friend and supporter of the Colburn School, Warner Henry. Warner was a respected member of the Board of Trustees, and I speak on behalf of myself and Martin when I thank him for his commitment to the school, its students, artists, faculty, staff, audiences, and partners. His presence and his passion for the performing arts will be missed, but not forgotten.
Hello again. Today is the sonata number 6 in A major, the second of Beethoven's 3 A major sonatas, Opus 30, number 1.
These A major sonatas, they are all one more different than another. Number 6, I find that is incredibly kind of suspended, almost impressionistic in the feeling. Still incredibly full of contrasts. It's typical Beethoven. I think it's a good halfway between the Spring Sonata and the 7th.
Yes, I would tend to agree. For me, this sonata, well, you don't hear it played quite as often as some others. Personally, I think that's because it's very hard
to play. Because it's very difficult.
this sonata is way more, I would say, esoteric.
Philosophically.
Yes, yes. And it takes a steady hand, and I would say a view of the bigger arc of the piece to really pull it off.
Yeah, it's basically one concept from the beginning to end for all 3 movements. Mm-hmm. That is not much of a challenge in changing character for our own self while we're playing, because you get inside a zone from the first bar and you've got to, the difficulty is maintaining this zone for the entire piece, not movement.
Yes.
So this is very challenging.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Again, this is a sonata without a traditional scherzo movement. Very, very interesting.
Yeah.
But that second movement is, at least when you play it, it feels at the same time very, very long, and it's over like that.
Yeah. It's the explanation of an entire life. And it is actually the very first time that he writes adagio molto espressivo, mm-hmm, as an adagio. Before we had andante, we had other things, but not adagio molto espressivo. And although the character is still, as you said, is very esoteric, it's basically the description of an entire lifetime. And that is what is very difficult to maintain the sense from the first to the last note.
Yeah. Yes, I agree. And I feel that that he, in general, is plunging to greater depths.
He's already exploring, yeah, absolutely.
In this sonata.
And we hope they enjoy it.
We do hope they enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.